enjoying himself in the state of his chosen reality, the Plutonian in his fictitious reality refused to respond to any stimulus applied by the Vespan soldiers. He just refused to wake up. Maybe out of guilt or just a delusional concept he feels comfortable in. A kind of comfort zone created within the cortex of his subconsciousness, which intentionally put him in a state of numbness to reality. This can be extrapolated to him mentally being in denial, and it was better for him to be in his constructed fantasy. This was shocking to the Vespa soldiers, for what sort of being is the Plutonian? A persona whom has the capability of locking himself away in his consciousness. They were impressed, but most importantly, they were sure that they can make him useful physically despite his state of mind by fitting him into an exoskeleton suit that is being remotely controlled by them, in which it was possible to control him mechanically. It is known that the Vespa soldiers invade and pillage planets' resources. But not only that, they also capture powerful beings from planets they invade and force them to work in dangerous and high radioactive mines, in which the Plutonian is also subjected to. The absence of the Plutonian blew people's mind to the roof. They couldn't believe it. It was like a dream. It was a joyous day for celebration. And trust Earthlings, they know how to party. And our hero survived. Joined in the celebration. He reveled in the adulation he was getting, and he was overwhelmed in the love he was receiving from everyone. He wanted to be loved. Especially when he took the glory for the defeat of the Plutonian, in which is known that it was a team effort. But the reality is that the people wanted a hero, a savior, someone they can trust again. And our hero, survivor, believes he is the qualified candidate. And this attitude irritated the hell out of Qubit, for he can see that the survivor is being carried away and overexcited, in which puts his decision-making questionable. Now, him being popular or being the best thing since sliced bread wasn't Qubit's problem. His problem with the survivor is his childish decision-making, in which he questioned him on his decision giving amnesty to nefarious, merciless, ruthless villains whom had done some dastardly and unspeakable things in the past. That such announcements promising amnesty to these individuals was going to create a chaotic problem for him, and that it was dangerous. That if he thinks he can create some harmonious unity among this bunch of merciless criminals, he is as delusional as the exiled Plutonian. And in fact, he's beginning to sound like the Plutonian. He can't even tell the difference. Qubit went further in questioning survivor's sincerity, in asking him why he isn't making any effort in looking for his brother Scylla, since it had been confirmed by Kaidan that there is a possibility that Scylla is still alive because she was unable to harness the spirit of Scylla, in which the survivor disingenuously replied that he thought Qubit was helping to look for Scylla, for he believes that Qubit is the only one intelligent and capable enough in looking for his brother, trying to cajole Qubit. But Qubit was not down with his unsubstantiated flattery, in which he questioned why survivor intentionally doesn't want to find his brother. Is it because he knows he has to share half of his powers with his brother and go back to his reclusive status and lose Kaidan? In furious anger, the survivor, who had enough of Qubit's accusation, blasted Qubit to the wall, letting him understand that he wants his brother back from the bottom of his heart, and that he would give anything to have his brother back to life, but sacrifices must be made. For if he had to share his powers with his brother again, that the world will not be safe, defenseless, and in complete jeopardy. That if not for his powers, he wouldn't have been able to face and fight an entity like the Plutonian. That Qubit and the whole world owes him gratitude and should be grateful, for he is the one doing the sacrifice by giving up on his brother. Qubit, still not backing down from Survivor's threat, made him understand one thing: that just because Scylla is not here won't make Kaidan love him. In which he told Qubit to stay out of his way and out of his sight, and that if he doesn't, the world will know that Qubit was an advocate for the Plutonian despite his evil ways, and that what happened to him at the village was just child's play. That imagine if he tells the world, he wouldn't have anywhere to hide. Now, most of the captured beings by the Vespa soldiers from other planets were no ordinary beings. Some of these beings were as powerful as the Plutonian. Some of them were powerful that they can split a planet in half. But due to the Vespa soldiers' advanced technology, they were able to subjugate them to an overwhelming submission, which is being projected by a graviton force which renders these beings motionless to the ground, and are forced to mine a mineral resource called thermite, which fuels their ship, and it is highly radioactive. Some of these beings don't survive it at the end of the day. The only person who was not affected by the graviton force was the Plutonian, unknowingly to the Vespa soldiers, for he was still in his fictitious reality, but his body was reacting against the graviton force in his numbness, locked inside his consciousness and not snapping out of it or even trying to wake up from his delirium. He was busy saving the world and being a hero, but all of a sudden his self-induced created beautiful world began to crash before him. Everything began to fall apart. He began to make mistakes that he abhorred. He was losing control and his lost nightmare began to resonate. Now the Vespa soldiers in a meeting felt a shake like tremor which shook their vicinity, indicating that something or someone among their prisoners was resisting the force of graviton used in suppressing their slaves. In trembling fear, the commander of the Vespa soldiers ordered that the graviton force should be increased 100-fold, which ended up crushing all the prisoners in the mine, except one, the Plutonian.